What's up, y'all? So today, we're going to be doing something a little bit different. So over the last week or so, I've actually had a couple people reach out to me personally, like, you know, friends and stuff, and ask me for product recommendations. It was funny because one of my friends actually said that she asked me because I was brown, like she was. And it dawned on me, oh my God, why don't I do a brown girl friendly drugstore recommendations video? This is gonna be like a drugstore brown girl friendly starter kit. The things, the essentials that you need in your collection to get started. I'm gonna be giving you guys shade recommendations and everything. I'm gonna show you guys what works for me and just all the bomb ass products at the drugstore, you know? Anyway, let's get started because this is gonna take freaking forever. I have so much to talk about. I actually have a couple recommendations in each category. So I'm gonna do a full face with you. I'm even gonna cover tools, okay? So get ready, sit down, grab a drink, a meal. I don't care what you do. Let's do this. Oh God. So I'm going to start with tools. And the first tool that I always use are sponges. So my favorite sponges are actually from Real Techniques. This is just their regular beauty sponge. And then this is actually their like face and body sponge. This is huge, y'all. This blends your foundation in like 2 seconds. It's huge. Like, that's what she said. I love them. They're squishy. They're soft. They're not too dense. You get good coverage. It doesn't soak up your product. And they're just really good sponges. There is no need to spend $20 on a beauty blender if you have these in your collection. I should probably like put all this shit away as I'm talking about it because I'm about to make a mess. The other sponge that I have, this is actually from e.l.f. I can't remember what they call this. I think this is like the Total Face sponge, but this is a really great sponge. I love the squishiness of this sponge. Okay, for brushes, I have to give it up to BH Cosmetics. BH Cosmetics has like the best brush sets at the drugstore. I love them. I love them more than I love my e.l.f. brushes. Now, I actually have two sets of the Crystal Zodiac collection. That's not from BH. How did you get in there? What else is in here? This is not from BH either. What's happening? Okay. This has to be like the most beautiful brush set that I own. Okay. Y'all look at these handles. They're like made out of like, you know, those precious stones or whatever. And the brushes are like so soft. Anytime I ever reach for a brush while I'm doing my makeup, for blush, for bronzer, for face powder, whatever, I always reach for this brush set first. And it's like a full ass brush set. So you get not only everything you need for your face, but you also get all kinds of eye brushes. Everything that you need in one set. And it's so affordable. I think it's like $30. You need it. Okay, for primer, I actually have just two options. And both of them are pore filling. I'm sorry, but that's what I look for in a primer. I have oily skin. I have giant pores. I need a good pore filling primer. And this one is my holy grail. This is my favorite primer of all time. High end, low end, whatever. This is from NYX. This is the Angel Veil. I just love how smooth this makes my face look. And it keeps my makeup looking flawless. All day. The other one is from e.l.f. This is the Matte Putty Primer. This is like this in a pot form, if that makes any sense. It makes me look super smooth. It makes me look flawless. This is actually the primer that I use today. And I just feel like my foundation lays so nicely on top of it. It just makes me look so smooth. I'm not gonna say poreless because them bitches is there, okay? Like, I also have two foundations to share with you guys. The first one is from ColourPop. This is the Pretty Fresh foundation. This is like your perfect everyday foundation. This is lightweight. It has medium coverage and it's just good for every day, you know, every day for the office or wherever the hell you work, retail, it doesn't matter. This wears nicely, it stays put, it doesn't break up on my oily skin, but it looks natural and fresh on the skin. And it's just a good lightweight everyday foundation. I would say the same thing about this one, but this is a little bit more glam than the Pretty Fresh foundation. This is from Morphe. This is actually the foundation that I'm wearing today. This is the Filter Effect Soft Focus foundation. This is a medium to full coverage foundation. So again, if you're into more coverage or more glam, this is gonna be your foundation. In the ColourPop foundation, I am in the shade medium dark 120W. And in the Morphe foundation, I am shade tan 17. Y'all, this Morphe foundation makes your face look flawless. It smooths over my pores. It actually blurs a lot of my own skin imperfections. And again, the coverage is really great. It's more of a satin matte finish. Why was that so hard to say? So this is probably better for my oily skin girls. The ColourPop foundation is better if you have like normal to dry skin. Both work for my oily skin though. I just have to set the ColourPop foundation real good. For concealer, I also have two options. The first one is also from ColourPop. This is the Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Creamy Concealer. I'm in the shade Medium Dark 115W. Again, good medium coverage. It looks really flawless on the skin. It looks super fresh. It looks healthy. It wears really well. And it's super lightweight, so it's really good for everyday. You know, your everyday woman. Like, you're going to the office, you're going grocery shopping. This is a really great concealer for that. The other concealer I have, I actually just got this. And I have been loving it. This is from The Ordinary. It just says concealer, high coverage formula. I'm in the shade 2.3N, medium neutral. Okay, this shocked me, okay? This concealer is $5.60, okay? Now, it's a little tube, but a little bit goes a long way. It has really good coverage, but it has like a matte finish, and it's like matte. Okay, so this is really good for oily skin. The Pretty Fresh concealer is good for your normal to dry skin. If you have dry skin, I don't think you're gonna like The Ordinary concealer just because it does look and feel a little drier. But again, it looks skin-like somehow. I don't know how it's so matte, but it looks skin-like. I've actually worn this on my face with nothing else, and it looks good on bare skin. Okay, for setting powder, I'm cheating a little bit because this first one you actually can't get at the drugstore, but it is affordable. I think you can order it on Amazon, or you can get it at Navy's or Nigel's, one of the two. This is from RCMA Makeup. This is the No Color Powder. This powder, y'all, is so skin-like. I feel like people with oily and dry skin will love this because it doesn't look like dry and cakey on your face. It's like a no trace powder. It's translucent. So when you set your foundation or concealer with this, it doesn't look like you put powder on your face. It just looks like it's just your face. Like, I don't know how to explain it, but it just works. The other powder I have is actually from Black Opal. This is in the shade Neutral Light 200. This is the True Color Soft Velvet Finishing Powder. Y'all, I love this powder. This powder actually reminds me of the Laura Mercier powder. It feels silky and smooth. It's not heavy, but it sets your face to perfection. This is actually the powder that I'm wearing today. Oh, and I'm also wearing The Ordinary concealer under my eyes. Flawless, okay? Just flawless. I feel like it actually blurs the skin. It fills in pores and it just looks really good on the face. It doesn't look heavy or thick or cakey. I keep trying the Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder and it doesn't look right. I don't know why. It looks thick and cakey on my skin. I don't know if it's because I'm oily, but this doesn't do that. It just, again, it reminds me so much of the Laura Mercier powder. It just looks and feels luxe on your face, okay? Just trust me. Okay, for bronzer. The only like single bronzer that I have to show you is this one from Milani. This is the Silky Matte Bronzer Powder in the shade Sunkiss 02. This is actually the bronzer that I'm wearing today. I love this because it looks just like my Fenty bronzer. Now the shade is different. This is actually a little bit cooler than my Fenty bronzer, but it actually blends out on my face exactly the way that my Fenty bronzer does. It looks almost airbrushed on your face. It looks smooth. It blends out to perfection. And I actually really love this shade because it looks like a real suntan. It doesn't look like too warm, but it's also cool enough to where you can contour with it. This is my favorite bronzer at the drugstore. The other bronzer I have is actually in a face palette. Y'all, okay, this is from Physicians Formula. This is the Butter Collection X Weili Huang. I always say that wrong. I know I'm saying it wrong. I'm so sorry. Anyway, I love this face palette. There are so many face palettes in my collection, and this is the only one that I actually reach for on a consistent basis, okay? I reach for this all the time because these two bronzers are like butter on the skin, okay? They look so glowy, so healthy, so just smooth. And I also love these blushes and these highlights. These highlights are a little bit sparkly for my liking. I just love how healthy these look on the skin, and I do feel like if you're a medium girl like me, these will show up on your skin. So will the blushes and these highlights. If you're a lot deeper than me though, Physicians Formula gotta step it up, okay? They have to. I know they made like a dark dark bronzer, but okay, dark for who, really? But this is one palette that does actually work for me. So again, if you're my shade or maybe one or two shades deeper than me, this will work for you. Okay, blush. I have so much blush. I love blush, okay? I have like a few options for blush. The first thing are these, okay? These are from e.l.f. These are pretty new. This is the Putty Blush. I actually have the shade... No shade. I can't remember what shades these are. Bahama and Tahiti, some, I can't remember. I'll put it on the screen, but these putty blushes look so good on the skin. If you're just on the go and you want something quick, just a little blush, a little mascara, an eyebrow, and you're done, you know? These are actually so good for oily skin because they don't feel greasy. They don't look cakey on the skin. They don't move your foundation around. They just look good. They look glowy without being like slippy and greasy and gross, you know? I really love the color payoff. They look pigmented, but they blend out so nicely. They just look really good, all right? The other two blushes I have are from NYX. These are the Sweet Cheeks Matte Creamy Powder Blushes. It's hard to explain these. So they're matte powder blushes, okay? I have the colors Silence is Golden and Summer Breeze. I'm actually wearing Summer Breeze today. It looks matte, okay? And it applies matte, but somehow there's like a luminosity to it. It's like a creamy matte. I don't understand, but it looks really healthy on the skin. They're pigmented. They blend out well. They just look good. Okay. Y'all need these. And the last set of blushes that I have, this is actually a palette. This is from BH Cosmetics. This is the Bellini 6-Color Blush Palette. Anytime I want a peachy blush, this is where I go. I love BH Cosmetics palettes because they're just so affordable. They're easy. They look good. They're pigmented. They blend well. I think they have a bronzer palette just like this as well. And I want it. I'm just saying, you need it. Okay, we're moving right along. The next category is highlighter. I have a few things, okay? The first thing is this, okay? This is my favorite highlight at the drugstore. This is from Wet n Wild. This is the Loose Highlighting Powder in the shade Hustle and Glow. Do y'all see that reflection there? I know y'all see it. Okay, this is a loose powder, but hear me out, okay? This loose highlighter is so smooth, okay? It looks so smooth on the skin. I don't understand, okay? It's smooth. It's not sparkly. It's metallic without being too much. You can go in with a light hand and it looks so natural. Or you can really go in and they'll see you from space, okay? Like, this is the best highlight at the drugstore, okay? I've tried other highlights. And with the exception of the next one that I'm gonna talk about, this is the only good one at the drugstore, okay? And I wanna say they have a deeper shade than this for deeper skin tones. This would be good for like medium to medium deep. And then they have one for like deep dark, you know? It's like a real pretty gold. It's like molten gold. It's beautiful. But if you're looking for a highlight that is gonna like make you stand out, it's this one, okay? You need this one. And as much as I hate loose highlights, like I hate loose highlights. I love this. I felt like I went on and on about that highlight. The next one is actually from Essence. This is the Pure Nude Highlighter. This is in the shade Be My Highlight. Y'all, this is like rubbing off because I have had this for so long. I love this highlight. This is the highlight that I wear on bare skin, okay? An eyebrow, some mascara, this highlight, and I'm out, y'all. I love to glow, okay? I love to glow. And this is... This is the kind of highlight that you wear where people are like, wow, is that her skin glowing? Or because it does look like it's just your skin. There is no sparkle. It's almost like a matte powder that gives you a glow. It's so weird, but it looks so smooth. It looks so good on the skin. It looks natural. This is for my people that do not like a metallic highlight. They're not looking to look like, I don't know, who wears a metallic highlight? Anyway, this is just for those people that aren't into those metallic, sparkly, like glittery highlights. This is gonna look so smooth, and they have a shade deeper than this for my deep girls, you know? And they have like a full ass like highlighting palette. This is also from Essence. This is the Pure Nude Highlighter Palette. This is actually what I'm wearing today. I'm wearing a combination of these two colors here. And y'all, you can't tell me this isn't smooth. My biggest gripe with highlights from the drugstore is that when I look straight on, one, you can see a stripe of white. It's like they're made with a white base. And like when I look straight at you, you can see a stripe. But with this, it just looks, you know, smooth and natural and just glowing from within. You know, I love this palette. I just, y'all need these. And again, they have a palette in a deeper shade for my deep girls. Let's do eyebrows. Okay, eyebrows. It's crazy because as of late, I have only been using drugstore products for my eyebrows. So the first must-have is this one from NYX. This is the Micro Brow Pencil. This is actually a dupe for the Anastasia Brow Wiz. Comes in a variety of colors, shades for everybody, totally inclusive. I love this. The formula is super smooth. It's not too waxy. It's not too pigmented. Your brows look bomb. If I reach for a pencil, it's gonna be this one. But as of late, I've been reaching for this one. This is actually a brow pen. This is also from NYX. This is the Lift and Snatch Brow Tint Pen. This is actually what I'm wearing in my brows today. I feel like this looks so natural. It looks like my natural brow hairs. I just love the like full feathery effect that I get from this. And I love that I can wear it when I'm not wearing a full face of makeup. And it just looks like my brows are full and feathery naturally. You know, I've also been loving this. This is weird. Okay. I have never actually tried a product like this. This is like a cross between a brow gel and like a wax. It's weird. The consistency is weird. This is also from NYX. This is the brow glue. It's goopy. Okay. It's goopy and it feels like you put wax, but it gives you like that laminated look, you know, where your brows are just like up. I love this. I feel like it keeps my brows in place and they just look like full and feathery and thick. You know, I love this. Okay, let's talk about eyeshadow palettes. The first few I'm gonna talk about are these. These are from e.l.f. These are the Bite Size Shadows in Truffles, Rosewater, and Pumpkin Pie. I wanna say these are like $3, $4. They're like buttery, they're pigmented, they blend well, they're good quality, and they're a few bucks, you know? And they have a lot of different like color schemes or whatever. They have something for everybody. That's all I ask, really. The other palette I have is this one. Now this is a lot, okay? This is a little excessive. But you have everything you need in this one palette. You can get a colorful look, you can get a neutral look, you can get a glam look, whatever you need. You know, this is from NYX. This is the Ultimate Utopia Shadow Palette. And again, I love the colors in here. Everybody can find a look out of this palette, you know? And the last palettes I have are from ColourPop. Now this is actually, these two are my favorite ColourPop palettes. This is the So Jaded palette. I don't know. I think this might've been limited edition. It might still be available. I don't know. I think definitely this one is still available. It should be if it's in stock. I don't know. This is the Sandstone palette. If you're looking for shadows that are affordable, that are good quality, that have just variety, you know, ColourPop is where it's at. They literally have everything, you know? They have everything for somebody or somebody. They have, what is it? They have something for everybody. That's what I'm trying to say. I mean, these colors, again, you can get a neutral look, you can get a colorful look, a full glam look. This is the palette that I'm wearing today. I've actually used just a bunch of neutral tones on my lids. But again, ColourPop is just, if you need a shadow, ColourPop is gonna have that shadow. Okay, now eyeliners. Now, not everybody goes for like colorful eyeliners, but I do. So if you're looking for colorful eyeliners that are brown girl friendly, something that's gonna show up on you, these are the ones to get, you know? These are from NYX. These are the Epic Eyewear Liner Sticks. They have these in like a bunch of different colors. I wanna say they also have a black and a white. So if you need something that's good quality, that's gonna stay on the waterline, that's not gonna budge or smudge or move, these NYX Epic Eyewears are awesome. Now, if you're looking for just off the wall colors, including black or white, and they have like a nude color, LA Girl. Okay, just turn to LA Girl. This teal, they have a bunch of different ones actually. So these two are like wooden, you sharpen them or whatever. They have all kinds of colors available. These two are retractable. I'm actually wearing this lavender one in my waterline today. If you need any kind of eyeliner, go to LA Girl. Just any kind of eyeliner. It doesn't matter. Liquid, pencil, retractable. It doesn't matter. Colorful, black. It just does make go to LA Girl. Okay, just go to LA Girl. Okay. Okay, for setting spray, these are the two that I would recommend. The first one is from Morphe. This is the Continuous Setting Mist. And the other one is from NYX. This is the Bear With Me Prime Set and Refresh Multitasking Spray. I love both of these for the exact same reasons. Okay, they melt your makeup into your skin. They look natural. They hydrate. They kind of take away that powdery look to your makeup. And they're both super affordable. I want to say both of these are actually dupes for MAC Fix Plus. I mean, it's a setting spray. There's not really a whole lot to say, you know? They set your makeup and just make your makeup look natural, you know? Okay, for mascara. Really, I don't like a lot of drugstore mascaras. I feel like a lot of them flake on me and they just don't give me the volume that I'm looking for, you know? This one is the only drugstore mascara that I've actually like loved. This is from NYX. This is the Worth the Hype mascara. I just have mine in black. I do think they have like other shades. I think they might have a brown. I'm pretty sure I have a blue in this exact same formula. But I just love the volume it gives. It makes your lashes look full and feathery without being super clumpy. This is actually the mascara that I'm wearing today. And again, it just gives me, it almost gives me the same effect that I get from my Pat McGrath mascara. It's a little bit less volume, but it feels just, your lashes just feel full and feathery and they just look good, you know? And it doesn't flake on me, which is so important. Okay, let's talk about lips. This is like the most difficult category for me because I feel like it is so hard to find a nude, period. But when you're brown, it's like all the nudes are white, like stark white. I don't understand. So I'm gonna share with y'all some of my favorite lipsticks, period, based on color, but also some of my favorite lipstick formulas. So the first thing I'm gonna share with you guys are lip liners. These are actually from e.l.f. These are from the Retro Paradise collection. I don't know if it's still available, but I'm pretty sure it is. I saw it at Target. I'm actually wearing the Nude 2 lip liner today underneath a liquid lipstick, but these are just, you know, it's like they made these for a brown girl. But I do really love these for the formula. They are wooden, but they're super creamy. They glide on and the color is spot on. Again, I'm wearing Nude 2 and it's just like my perfect nude lip liner. Do you know? The other one that I wanted to talk about is actually from ColourPop. This is the Lippy Pencil in the shade BFF2. If you're wearing like a pinky nude, even if you're wearing a brown nude, this goes perfect with everything. I love the formula of these. I kind of hate sharpening it because it's like one of those like plastic pencils, but I do love how creamy the formula is. I love how it looks on the lips. Sometimes I'll wear just this on the lips and nothing else, maybe throw on a gloss or a lip balm on top. I love their formulas and they do have colors for everybody. Like everybody has a lip liner that they can wear from ColourPop. Okay, let's talk about lipstick. First of all, I just wanted to shout these out. These are from e.l.f. These are the Ride or Die lip balms. These are tinted lip balms. They actually remind me of the Bite Beauty Agave lip balms, but I just love these because they are tinted. They look just so good on the lips and they're super hydrating. I wear these like on a daily basis. For liquid lipsticks, I actually don't really wear liquid lipsticks all that often because they're too dry and there's just not a formula at the drugstore that I absolutely love, except for this. This is the ColourPop Ultra Blotted Lip. This is in the shade Starling. This is like my perfect nude. This is what I'm wearing on top of that other lip liner that I was talking about, and I love this. It feels thin but comfortable on the lips. It's not too dry. It doesn't accentuate every crack, every wrinkle in my lips, which is the reason why I hate liquid lipsticks now. But this feels super comfortable. It moves with my lips and I love the color. This is, again, my perfect nude and I'm obsessed. Anytime I want to wear like a true nude, this is the one that I go for. Okay, the last thing I have to talk about are bullet lipsticks, okay? Now, there's only two formulas at the drugstore that I absolutely love. The first one is from Milani. These are just, I don't know, they're regular bullet lipsticks. I'm pretty sure all of these are matte. They do have like creamy formulas and satin formulas and stuff, I don't know. But these are actually my favorites. These I purchased when I first started getting into makeup and they're still here because I just love them that much. I do have a nude. This is in 55 Bahama Beige. And again, I love the formula of that. It feels creamy on the lips. It doesn't feel super dry. The other two I have are Matte Glam 65 and Matte Flirty 71. I feel like the Milani bullet lipsticks are actually dupes for the MAC matte lipsticks in the Bullet. Does that make sense? If you can't go get a MAC lipstick, you can go get Milani.
I love those.
And then the other ones are from Maybelline. I actually have these just in bold colors. I have 805 Orange Danger, 820 Berry Bossy, and 810 Fiery Fuchsia. Again, very similar to the MAC Bullet lipsticks. I feel like if you can't get those, this is a very, very close dupe. And I just love the colors. I love the formula. I love how it looks on the lips. It's not too drying. And they're just really good lipsticks, you know? And they're cheap. I think they're like $8 a tube, I think. Anyway, that's it. That is my brown girl friendly guide to the drugstore. If you're just starting out, these are the products that I would recommend getting. They're good quality, but they're also super affordable and they're brown girl friendly, you know? I don't know where I heard. I can't remember who told me or if I read it in an article, but I know that like drugstores normally cater to their demographic. So if you go to a drugstore, let's say in Beverly Hills, they're gonna cater to that demographic. And I actually live in an area that's predominantly white. I mean, I don't see a whole lot of brown people. So my drugstore stocks more like lighter shades than medium to deep shades, just because that's the demographic around here. So I hope this video was helpful in at least kind of figuring out where you fall in the shade ranges, you know, so that you can order online if you need to. I know for most of my products, I actually order them on Ulta online, just because I feel like, you know, I'm always gonna find my shade. I just think it's so frustrating going into my local Ulta or my local drugstore and finding products that I'm interested in, but they're not in my shade. I think it's so frustrating. Anyway, let me know if you guys would like to see like a higher end version of this. So like if you're going to like a Sephora or the high end section at Ulta, I do have like recommendations, things that if you're just starting out, products that are worth the money that, you know, I think y'all should have. Anyway, let me know if you guys are interested in that. I'll totally do that. That's it. That's all I got today. I hope you guys enjoyed, you know, subscribe and stay tuned. I have like hair everywhere. My hair keeps falling out. It looks frizzy and it's hot in here. And for some reason, this video looks like real close, real close. This is gonna be like your starter kit, your Kurt. Again, our brown girl friendly. Can I say that one more time? Like, so I can't deal with you right now. Go lay down, Dejo. Good girl. You gotta lay down. Oh, Jijix. Oh, Dejo.
Did you eat this? Did you eat this?
What was in there?
I don't know, but he probably ate it.
Well, I don't think there was anything left in there.
Nope.
What are you doing?
I'm just grabbing some.
What are you grabbing?
These.
I can't put them in. Come, Jax.
The best brush sets. Why is my hair in here? Wow, I'm gonna be here for a while. I just got started and I'm already 10 minutes in. Okay, let's go. Silence and gold is gold. Silence and golden. How long? Okay, 20 minutes, 20 minutes. Not bad. Not bad. This is from Wet n Wild. This is, this is why I never let my hair down. It's hot, I'm tangled, I'm frizzy. What's happening? I can't. Oh god, I suck at this. Yules. Yes. You're welcome.
You're so cute, man.
Oh my god, I need to hurry. Oh my god, I need to hurry. Oh my god, Zoe.
In which box is this?
It's like I film and everybody just has to come in here to grab stuff, to do things. Zoe's walking around. Can I film? It doesn't take long. I just want to finish this. Goes for colorful eyeliner. Max Fix Plus. That's really hard to say. It makes your lashes look feathery. Did I say it makes? Oh man, I'm so stupid. Wait. Your lashes, did it break? Motherfucker. Somewhat helpful in at least trying to, I don't know why I just can't talk. Is it because I'm trying to talk fast and I can't really talk fast?